now let's talk about choosing an IDE or integrated development environment for writing Java applications. Actually have a lot of options if you want to create Java apps. You could even use a plain text editor, write your code files, compile them, and run them through the command line. So if you want to go the most raw way possible, that is an option. However, for this course, we're going to be using a full IDE so that we could take advantage of code hinting, if we want to later on, source control, and other features that make life easier when creating Java apps. For those options, some of the most popular ones are Eclipse, IntelliJ IDEA, and NetBeans. So why would you want to choose one of these IDEs over the other? In this comparison table, you can see that all of them have a free version available, they're all cross-platform, and they all support multiple programming languages. So what it comes down to is personal preference and an IDE that meets your specific needs. You might choose Eclipse because you've used it before in developing other applications and you're comfortable with it. You might choose IntelliJ IDEA because you've developed Android applications before, and Android Studio is based on IntelliJ IDEA, so you might already be familiar with that interface. You might choose NetBeans because you want an IDE that's supported by the creator of Java, which is Oracle. You also might choose NetBeans because it has excellent support for databases and server-side Java applications. In this course, we're primarily going to be focused on Eclipse. NetBeans is an excellent IDE, and while earlier versions of NetBeans were excellent for developing web applications, the current version of NetBeans has been taken over by Apache, and its support for building web applications is still growing. So maybe in the next year or two, we'll see some progress there. But for now, I don't recommend NetBeans for developing Java web applications.